Welcome to Coohom Architect, your one-stop solution for comprehensive interior and exterior house design. Let's dive into the interface first. The left side panel serves as an essential toolbox for house modeling, categorized into build, decorate, material, and library. We can generate house plan by tracing images or DWG files. Space Planner tool also gives you a quick way to get house plan from room bubbles. We offer the most basic tools here for building a house, including wall, roof, and slab. You can find the doors and windows needed for modeling in the doors and windows. Other common building components are available in the arch and structures. For creating irregular or unconventional shapes, you can leverage the 3D modeling tool. In the decorate part, it includes the decoration of roofs, walls, doors, windows, and columns. You can check out the diagram to understand the usage of them. Once the main structure and decoration of the building are done, you'll need to head to the material part for tasks like applying tiles and roofing with shingles. The library is stocked with furnishing. Just drag and drop to add them to your plan. The central drawing area is the main canvas. That's where we do most of our work. Now let's learn to control the view with your mouse. Click and drag with the left button to rotate the view. Click and drag with the right button to pan the view. Scroll the wheel to zoom in and out. If you get lost, click the reset button or press space to return to the default view. In the top right corner, the side view mirrors the central main view. It shows a 2D view when the main view is 3D and switches to 3D when the main view goes to D. The side view can be scaled, collapsed, and expanded. In the main view, the blue grid is the active elevation working plane for drawing. You can switch planes here, or use the up or down arrows to change to adjacent planes. Switching planes in the 2D view, you'll see the floor plans of different levels. In the bottom right corner, the first button toggles between Show Interior and Show All. The second button acts as a visibility switch. When ticked, it enables you to manage the display of building components. The third button is Camera Settings. It allows you to save custom viewpoints for quick access later. Adjust the camera's height and FOV, and toggle between Orbit and Walk modes. While in Walk mode, you can steer the camera with the arrows at the bottom of the screen, or by using the W, A, S, D, E, Q on your keyboard. The fourth one is the Display Mode button, which allows you to switch between different display effects. When no object is selected, the right panel allows for quick creation and duplication of floors. Once an object is selected, the right panel displays its properties, which you can adjust. In the top bar, the File menu provides options for creating, opening, saving, and renaming projects. Be cautious with the Clear button. It will delete all your design work with a single click. The toolkit includes handy drawing aids like the material brush and the measurement tool. Renderer is divided into architectural and interior. In architectural renderer, you can use different scenes for rendering. The scene is displayed in low poly form here, but don't worry, the rendering results will be in high fidelity models. You can adjust the scene's location and scale relative to your house directly on the canvas. Choose the ratio and resolution here, then click Render to generate the renderings. You can create renderings in three formats: photo, panorama, and video. The interior renderer is exactly the same as that in Coohom. The rendering results are saved in the gallery. After completing the exterior design, clicking on Design Interior in the top right corner will take you to the interior design environment. There are plenty of tutorials available on the Coohom site, so I won't go into detail here. Just remember, to return to the exterior design environment, simply navigate to the first button Exterior in the left sidebar, or use Edit in Exterior in the right Properties panel. That wraps up our tour of the tool interface. Are you all ready to roll up your sleeves and start designing? Try it now!